Hello, everyone, and welcome to Google Maps Developers Live. I'm Paul Saxman, and with me this week is Mano Marks. As you probably know, Google is committed to bringing Google Maps and Maps applications to as many different platforms as possible. So today, we're really excited to talk about the release of the latest version of the Google Maps SDK for iOS, version 1.1. We can also announce that keys are available to everyone through the Google APIs console.
We're going to take a look at some of the features of the SDK and how you can get started with them. We'll be demoing from an app that actually comes with the SDK, so once you have a key, you can put that in the app and test it for yourself. First and foremost, you see that you get access to Google's base map with the same street map data you get on the Android and JavaScript Maps APIs. You also get access to our terrain and satellite imagery, the largest and most comprehensive collection of imagery in the world. And we're constantly updating and improving our data without you having to make any updates or changes to your application. There are some other interesting features here. For instance, you get markers with info windows. We're going to switch over to the marker sample application. Here you see the basic Google map with a marker on it. You can do smooth zooming and panning with gestures, and because our maps are on iOS are vector-based, you can also rotate and tilt the map. Also, you can tailor the content of the info windows. Now we're going to check out the camera sample. You can programmatically zoom and tilt the map, and you can see 3D buildings come into view nicely rising out of the map. Looking over at the ground overlays demo, you can get these ground overlays, which are images that you can place on top of the map. And they can be anything from your own imagery to copies of old maps to pictures of flags or logos. Here we're rotating this Google logo to show you how to do rotation in your app.
There's a lot more in the SDK that you get access to, such as polylines and traffic information. And since it's a Google map, you can overlay data on it from any of the Google Maps web services, such as the Places API or Directions API. When you're ready to check it out, visit developers.google.com/maps, register for an API key at the Google API console, and if you have any questions, head over to Stack Overflow for quick answers.
Thanks for joining us, and see you next week.